Hello and welcome. We are running through every mission from Halos 1 through 3, Reach, and then playing Halo 4 for the first time. Today we're going to go through the Maw. I'm very excited. Two betrayals and keys, and the library to some extent. Not my favorites. Just the final end sequence of the Maw is going to make up for any of that. Not that I didn't like the, you know, not that I didn't like the previous three, but as far as what would you say your favorite levels are, those definitely ain't it. But the Maw I do like.
It'll hold.
We're not gonna make it.
We'll make it.
Pull up! Pull up! You did that on purpose, didn't you?
One thing I do want to point out really quickly. Once I finish Halo 1's Legendary Campaign, I'm going to take a break for approximately 1 week, maybe two. Cut some different short videos from what I've done so far, just anything that I think would be entertaining, worthwhile, or funny, mostly at my expense, like the bridge on Two Betrayals. So, just FYI, I will be taking a break to cut some short videos from what I've done already, and then once I'm done with that, I will schedule those out to release once a day, and then I will start on the Halo 2 Legendary Campaign and go through that kind of in a similar fashion, just doing one mission a day when I can. So
we need to get to the bridge. From there we can use the captain's neural implants to initiate an overload of the ship's fusion engines. The explosion should damage enough systems below it to destroy the ring.
Thank you.
Definitely forgot about those guys.
Should give us enough time to make it to a lifeboat and put some distance between ourselves and Halo before the detonation.
I'm afraid that's out of the question, really.
Oh, hell.
Ridiculous! That you would imbue a warship's AI with such a wealth of knowledge? Weren't you worried it might be captured? Or destroyed?
He's in my data arrays, a local tab.
You can't imagine how exciting this is, to have a record of all of our lost time. Human history, is it? Fascinating. Enjoy every moment of its categorization. To think that you would destroy this installation as well as this record. I am shocked. Almost too shocked for words.
Please stop the self-destruct sequence.
Why do you continue to fight us, Reclaimer? You cannot win. Give us the construct, and I will endeavor to make your death relatively painless and...
At least I still have control over the comm channels.
Where is he?
I'm detecting taps throughout the ship. Sentinels, most likely. As for the monitor, he's in engineering. He must be trying to take the core offline. Even if I could get the countdown restarted, I don't know what to do.
How much firepower would you need to crack one of the engine shields?
Not much. A well-placed grenade, perhaps, but why?
Classic.
Okay, I'm coming with you. Chief, Sentinels!
Come on now.
The ship was heavily damaged when it crashed. Head to the cryo chamber. We should be able to get to the engine room through there.
Come on, man. If I can get killed in here, I'll be impressed. Probably very annoyed, but impressed nonetheless. Come on, man. Here we go. No frag grenades.
Engine room located. We're here. Alert! The monitor has disabled all command access. We can't restart the countdown. The only remaining option is to detonate the ship's fusion reactors. That should do enough damage to destroy Halo. Don't worry, I have access to all of the reactor schematics and procedures. I'll walk you through it. First, we need to pull back the exhaust couplings. That will expose a shaft that leads to the primary fusion drive core. Good! Step one complete! We have a straight shot into the fusion reactor. We need a catalyst explosion to destabilize the magnetic containment field surrounding the fusion cells. To use an explosive, I recommend a grenade or rocket. If you run out of explosives, there is an armory station located near the engine room's entrance. Analyze it. Fusion reactor number one destabilizes. Use explosives on the other three reactors. That should be enough to trigger a wildcat explosion.
Come on, man. This might actually be kind of tough. Because those stupid little pimple poppers.
Engine room located. We're here.
Can set off chain reactions of grenades.
Alert! The monitor has disabled all command access.
That would
we
not
can't restart the countdown.
The
only
ideal.
Remaining option is to detonate
is
the ship's fusion reactors. That should do enough damage to destroy Halo. Don't worry, I have access to all of the reactor schematics and procedures. I'll walk you through it. First, we need to pull back the exhaust couplings. That will expose a shaft that leads to the primary fusion drive core.
Come on, man.
Good. Step one complete. We have a straight shot into the fusion reactor. Catalyst explosion to destabilize the magnetic containment field surrounding the fusion cells. Use an explosive. I recommend a grenade or rocket. If you run out of explosives, there is an armory station located near the engine room's entrance. Analyzing. Fusion reactor number one destabilizing. Use explosives on the other three reactors. That should be enough to trigger a wildcat explosion of the engines.
exploded.
Only one more fusion reactor to go.
Surrender the construct to me, or I will be forced to take the construct.
That.
Keep it up.
Is
only one more
ridiculous.
Fusion reactor to go.
I think I'm gonna drop down and get me some health. I literally can't get past them.
Only one more fusion reactor to go.
That is ridiculous. Yeah, I know they continue to multiply. They're not even giving me room to get past. Ridiculous. There we go. This is
only one more fusion reactor to go.
This is gonna get annoying real fast.
Why do you continue to resist us, McLaren?
gonna say, I don't know how you can take a shotgun blast from that close. Still keep on living, Mr. Flood.
Outside and signal for evac. Accessing schematics. There's a service lift at the top of the engine room. It leads to a Class 7 service corridor that runs along the ship's dorsal structure. Hurry!
Just confusing. Come on now. Okay. Give me a break. There was nothing near me. Okay, no mystery flying objects. Okay. All right. Now we can get to the good part.
Cortana to Echo 419. Come in, Echo 419.
Roger, Cortana. I'm reading 555.
The Pillar of Autumn's engines are going critical, Foehammer. Request immediate extraction. Approach the crash site and be ready to pick us up at External Access Junction 4C as soon as you get my signal.
Affirmative. Echo 419 going on station. Echo 419 to Cortana. Things are getting noisy down there. Everything okay?
Negative. We have a wildcat destabilization of the ship's fusion core. The engines must have sustained more damage than we thought.
Analyzing. We have 5 minutes before the fusion drives detonate. We need to evac now. Activating final countdown timer. When it reaches zero,
Oh, are you kidding me?
The explosion will generate a temperature of almost 100 degrees.
I don't like that. Not, we're doing that again. That was the dumbest way to get knocked out of a Warthog I think I've ever seen.
Analyzing. We have 5 minutes before the fusion drives detonate. We need to evac now. Activating final.
You've got to be effing kidding me. No. Nope, I don't accept it. I don't accept it.
We have five minutes before the fusion drives detonate.
Well, at least I wasn't inside the warp pod.
Activating final countdown timer. When it reaches zero, the engines will detonate. The explosion will generate a temperature of almost 100 million degrees.
Okay.
Don't leave the area when it blows.
I would literally rather start over than get knocked out of a warthog.
Analyzing. We have 5 minutes before the fusion drives detonate. We need to evac now. Activating final countdown timer. When it reaches zero, the engines will detonate. The explosion will generate a temperature of almost 100 million degrees. Don't be here when it blows.
I'll own messing up on the actual course. I am not surrendering to some random explosions.
Analyzing.
That almost kill me.
That's
crazy.
The fusion drives detonate. We need
that
to
is crazy.
Now. Activating
some
final
random explosions
timer.
Almost kill you.
The engines will detonate. The explosion will generate a temperature of almost 100 million degrees.
All right.
Don't
third time's a charm. What is going on here? Nope. Nope. We'll be doing this uninterrupted.
Analyzing. We have 5 minutes before the fusion drives detonate. We need to evac now. Activating final countdown timer. When it reaches zero, the engines will detonate. The explosion will generate a temperature of almost 100 million degrees. Don't be here.
Just kill me. I've never seen Halo Legendary do this. This must be a remastered edition thing.
Analyze. We have 5 minutes before the fusion drives detonate.
I've never seen this much foolishness.
We need to evac now. Activating
it's
final
not
countdown
harder
timer.
If it's just
zero,
more frustrating. That's not really a test of skill. How frustrating can I make this?
Don't.
Slightly better. Not by much. Thank you. more out of a Warthog on this level in my life. In that way, it is more difficult, but
she's gone. Calculating alternate still. Escape route. Ship's inventory shows one longsword fighter is still docked in Launch Bay 7. If we move now, we can make
the
it.
Same, but it doesn't. It's like it's more front heavy.
We're cutting it close.
Didn't grab Johnson's cheeks.
Shut them down. We'll need them later. Fancy a look?
Master Chief's victory and the Arbiter's greatest failure.
Did anyone else make it?
Scanning. Just dust and echoes. We're all that's left. We did what we had to do for Earth. An entire Covenant armada obliterated and the Flood. We had no choice. Halo, it's finished.
No, I think we're just getting started.
Keep in mind, if I'm remembering correctly, to this point, no one had obliterated an entire Covenant armada like that. Which, clearly, they didn't obliterate everyone because the Arbiter survived. Well, I hope you've enjoyed going through Halo Combat Evolved with me. I've enjoyed it despite the different points where I got frustrated. So, gonna take a little bit of a break, make some funny little clips, anything that I think would be interesting to people who obviously aren't willing to watch 1 to 2 hours per level. So, in any case, we'll take a little bit of a break, probably about 1 to 2 weeks, put out some little shorts here and there, and then come back with Halo 2 on Legendary. And yeah, so thank you for watching. Hope you have a great weekend. See you later.